fighting in a new corner. Ladies and gentlemen, make welcome for Adeyemi Sands of Bayani.
Checking by force. And
his opponent. Fighting in the blue corner. Ladies and gentlemen, make welcome for Adeyemi Sands. Oh, Adeyemi.
Getting ready for this man. Who doesn't seem to be a perturbed mind? Big and supposed to be.
Thank you very much.
Slightly
and now let's introduce the ringside judges for this bout.
All of them.
Ladies and gentlemen, George 1, Segun Adesanya. George number 2, Sheyi George. And George number 3, Latif Muiz. The referee for this bout is Tola Jacobs. And this one is a national bantamweight challenge contest. 6 rounds of boxing. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. And he's fighting out of Ibadan, Owode Academy in Ibadan, Nigeria. He weighs 54.5 kilograms coming into the fight. He's making his debut in the world of professional boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, Habib Ige Oladeji. And his opponent, fighting across the ring in the blue corner, is fighting out of Abule Egba in Lagos, Nigeria. He weighs 54.5 kilograms. His record, he has had 3 fights, 2 wins, 1 coming by way of knockout, and 1 draw. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the hard-hitting, the sensational Adeyemi Sands of Bayani. And now the referee will give its instructions.
I'm ready. Ready.
Guys, my name is Tola Jacobs. The promise is to be exciting.
Relatively unknown Adeyemi Sands, Adeyemi in Ibadan, that is. Oh, probably because his opponent is a son of the soil, as we say it here in Nigeria. He hails from Oyo State, talking about Oladeji Habib. And he's got a lot of raucous crowd and support from the stands here. Let's see how he goes. We're going to round one of this 6 rounds contest. It's a national bantamweight challenge of the Ileya Boxing Fiesta. And you can see Adeyemi Sands again doing what he knows how to do best, dancing and weaving his way out of dangerous situations. It's still early days though.
Early days, yeah, but quite evident that he's got a better footwork and he's quite nimble and likes to move around a lot, which is a very good asset for any boxer.
Once again, he dances his way out of that one there. And I'm not even sure who the fans are actually supporting here. You can look at Sands there, ducking everything, reminding you of the one and only Floyd Mayweather Jr. In his own bouts.
Yes, this seems to be very explosive. The other guy, Olade Jabib, seems to be fearless too, even in the face of all the antics of the more experienced sense. He's showing that he's fearless as well, and he's ready to have a go at his more experienced opponent. This is quite explosive, coming from two young boxers.
That's what you will always get from him, and you can see Oladeji not being perturbed by all the displays of sense, but sense of combining very well, and you can see Habib there, spot on by his fans, trying to get sense, but he's not been able to connect, and Adeyemi quickly connects with a right jab there, which actually catches. But the thing about sense, he does fight very sensibly, protects himself very well, and I think he waits for you. To opponents, most times exhaust yourself and then I come out like a smoking gun.
And that is a path being currently trended by his opponent, Habib Oladeji. He got him there, and I'm afraid Habib Oladeji might just exhaust himself and open himself up for sense to go for the kill.
Look at those combinations there coming from sense and right. And he's using, and again, another beautiful right shot there. Combining that, those body punches and the headshots. Look at, just weaving his way out of every Habib trying to throw at him.
Sense has shown some good defense and he's getting his clean shot, body shot, jabs, and he's just waiting for that one opportunity to take that clean shot that will probably knock out his opponent.
Sneaky boxer is Sense, who's receiving a whole lot of punches here, but is watch that again, and he's getting himself out of it once again, and the fans are going bonkers right here at the Miaola Stadium.
Clear gold pugilistic skill being showed by Sense. That's why he got his name.
With him, he might get himself in trouble. What he needs to do is keep beating his time. He will get it, and you could see that Sense also trying coming into it. Both of them punching very, very hard here, and Ige has been called. I don't know where, and he catches Opaemi Sense there, but then Opaemi always seems unfazed whenever he gets punched. Look at body punches coming in there from Opaemi, trying to break down his opponent.
Credit to Oladeji, he's been able to take all those body punches in his stride. Credit to him as well again. He's got good punches, but one thing he clearly lacks, that his opponent, who is more experienced as, is the skill to weave out of troubled positions, troubled spots, and take the advantage when he sees it. Though we are yet to see it, but clearly, I think it's on the horizon.
A big mistake. Oh, that's a fantastic right one. Another one again. Coming from both boxers, and Opaemi seems to be calmer now and really delivering the shots and getting his points in there. He scored close to punches right there in the space of 1 minute there. Both boxers, this is obviously showing bright future of Nigerian boxing as young boxers slug it out here in the main bowl of the Obafemi Awolowo Stadium.
Jabib is clearly spot on by the fans, but he got caught there. And I'm afraid, if he keeps to this tactics, if he keeps to this strategy, he might just be his undoing in this one. Because clearly, Okoyemi Sense is a better fighter from their records. And this is just his first fight. He should be careful, tread carefully, not to expose himself. Because that's what I've felt for him all along.
He's a thinking boxer. Every time he finishes a round, it's like he x-rays the round, where he's actually weak and what he's not doing right. And I think that's what the corner of Ige, who is Oladeji Abib, need to do. And they're roughing it. I think they do this way, Ige might just find himself on at a very good position, because he seems to like, you know, getting stuck in it and just throw as many punches as we can. Just trying to unsettle Sense, but because Sense is more of the calmer and the more skillful fighter, as we have said earlier.
The approach he is taking is neither here nor there, because all of the punches he's thrown, trying to ruffle him up, he's been unfazed. Sense has been unfazed, and he's been able to take all of those punches in his stride. And I think they have to fashion out another means of getting under the skin of Sense, because like you said, something that is clearly going for Sense is because he's a cerebral fighter.
But you must also give kudos to that man there, Oladeji Abib, who's been a popular now, found himself a sitting duck before, but right now I think he's learned the fact that from his corner that he needs to work the upper body.
Another impressive thing from Ige is that he's backing himself. He's setting himself up for this bout. You can't go into a boxing match, especially the first time, against a more experienced opponent and not backing yourself.
Sense almost trying to set up Adedeji will not budge at all. He's stepping up every time, not allowing himself to be backed into the ropes. The pace, of course, having dropped. Both boxers have been a bit just at this point in time. Both of them can act. And he actually scores a big one there. Smells blood, and he actually went for it there. Of course, his fans also urging him on.
Credit to him. He smells blood, and he went for it. But Sense again, got out of that one. He got out of jail because the punch he landed rattled him. He tried to follow it up, but since quickly whipped out of that position, not to allow his opponent have the better of him that time.
This is going to be a very tough one for the judges, I must say. So far, so good. Earlier, Sense had the upper hand, but this round, Ige, talking about Oladeji Abib, has really stepped up.
No doubt about it. It's been Ige all the way in this round.
Absolutely fantastic boxing bout we're watching here. Explosion all the way right from round one up to round four that we are in right now. And we've seen two different styles of boxing. The one who's full frontal, aggressive, in Abib Oladeji, who's scoring a few more points at this point in time. And the other one who's a bit more calculating and more of a counter-attacking boxer.
Yeah, for Oladeji Abib, his coaches must have seen something, some flaw in the fight of Sense for them to have stuck to this Gongo style he's adopted since the start of the fight. But so far, so good. I think it's paid off for him. He's going Gongo, and he doesn't seem to be tired a bit. But for Sense, he showed why he's called Sense time and time again in this bout.
Using a whole lot of upper body movement as usual and waiting for that kill to come. And he's probably throwing a lot more variety of punches. You see a whole lot. That's another big one there. You see that counter-attacking move there, sticking his left hand out there to frustrate or just make his opponent lose concentration there. But Abib is not going to be perturbed at all. Keeps coming forward every time he gets the chance.
He's not going to let Sense run over him. He's a debutant, but so far, you think you mistake him for a pro of about 2-3 years. He's not going to let Sense run over him, even though he's shown some dexterity, some movement, some footwork, and some clean punches. He's just standing in there, showing resilience, and telling him, I'm going to be in your face for the entire fight.
Absolutely. And that's the way to fight someone like Sense. You can't just give him a field day anytime. And there that round goes, and we go on to the penultimate round here. It's a close one. It's a close one. But I still feel the man in yellow, probably still trying. This one, just be the one with the pop with the mad,
I'm going to agree with you on that one, and I think I I suspect the next round is the round where Sense and even the other guy, Oladeji Abib, will want to end it. He'll go for the kill.
I think there's a kill in this one. I think it's going to go on. We go round six, and it does look, it might just go all the way. I think for me, 70% chance of this going all the way, except something big happens in this fifth round. Once again, Sands dancing his way out of this one. Quick punches there. Good job coming in there.
Sense reminds me of a certain Oscar De La Hoya, who was a flamboyant boxer in his days. And he's got every trapping, Sense, I mean, every trapping of a flamboyant boxer. He's shown it time and time again. He can weave himself out of a trouble position, and he can throw the punches as much as he can take it.
Once again, dancing in, taking all those body punches and weaving himself off again. And you can also see Oladeji himself knowing where to back off at times. I think he spots the fact that he might be trying to suck, Sense trying to suck him into a very good area for himself, but he stands back again after a while. Abib is not just giving Sense any space at all.
Credit to him, as much as he's going on goal, I think he's very technical, and he knows, like you said, when to back off, when to attack, and I think the coaches have done really well in grooming this young Oladeji.
A future is bright for both of them, I must say. And Sense still doing his own thing. And then you can see nice defense coming up from Abib there, who himself goes for the body punches. And both of them trying to tire each other out. One thing I'm so impressed with is, that's a big left and right hook there coming from Sense. And he catches him again, misses that one.
Niron, well, I wonder if national team selectors are present here today, because this is a good fight. The two boxers have given us a spectacle, and clearly there's a future for these two young boxers on show here now.
But we all know that they can't go into the amateur ranks anymore because they are already into the pros. But then, of course, the MBBFC is very well present here because they literally sanctioned this bout in conjunction with the Oyo State Boxing Board of Control, who have all their big guns right here. So we're looking forward to a big one. Lewis Promotion, who is actually run by a man who is based in the United States himself, Henry Lewis, definitely here as well. And I'm pretty sure they'll be looking to pick some of these young boys up and see whether they can help them further their career or careers in the United States, where we know is the mecca of boxing.
They've got a good opportunity on the platter. And so far, so good. In the present fight, the two guys have shown their mettle, and they've shown us they can mix and match all of the things that are required to become a good boxer.
Absolutely. I love the fact that both boxers, very, very ferocious boxers, at the end of the fight, you have their touch gloves. So, you know what? I respect you, and I'm pretty sure that Sense, if you ask him at the end of this fight, he will definitely tell you that that man is so much. Talking about Abib Oladeji.
Really, I agree with you. If this is not the toughest fight he's ever fought in his life, clearly it's going to be up there amongst some of the toughest opponents he's come up against in his career.
You carry woman go club, you spend all your money.
Seconds out! Round 6, the final round!
And here we go. Officer corner quickly talking about Abib Oladeji. And finally, they get to touch gloves for the last time as they come out also for the last time. Round 6 of this superb national bantamweight challenge here at the main bowl of Bafemi Awolowo stadium. And I sense that this man, Oladeji Abib, would not want to leave anything to chance. I think he wants to go for the kill finally now. But whether or not he can do it is another thing. He's really getting his opponent, I must say. But he needs to be careful, like you said.
Well, this bout is evenly poised, and whoever takes this round, from the look of things, might be the winner of this bout. And so far, so good in this round. We've seen Abib Oladeji land some two incredible punches. But we'll wait to see where the pendulum finally swings.
I think this is also where Sense needs to be a bit careful. I think he should look at it that he might be in the lead. But that's a big... Oh, those are two big punches coming from Sense there. But this man definitely has a very strong jaw, chin, talking about Abib Oladeji. I saw those two left and right combinations coming in there, but he seemed unmoved at all.
Clearly, when like you said, Ige is standing up to him again, standing in his face. I'm not going nowhere. I'm going to stand here till the end of the bout.
Tries to go for the uppercut there, Sense, but didn't get through in that one. Oh, and definitely connects with that one later on. But then, of course, Abib standing right there, not giving Sense any ounce of space at all. It's been a brilliant fight right from the first round all the way to the sixth round. And it does look like this might go away as almost halfway into this final round.
Absolutely, they've been at each other's face, toe to toe. They've pound, and none of them giving his opponent anything to work with. And that was a very big punch.
That was stacking from the hands of Sense there, right one. But then every time, oh, another big left there coming from Sense. But once again, Abib standing in there as well. Oh, and another big one again. Both of them almost catching themselves at the same time. But you know what? I think once again, Sense has gone into that defensive mode, always trying to, you know, oh, he got caught there with a nice right jab coming from Abib. Those three big punches of Sense could decide this bout.
Clearly, in the final round, the approach of Sense has been, and go back into your shell. That landed, that gave him an opportunity to land three big punches, and he just to do that. With some camaraderie between them. Whoever wins this fight, in my opinion, there's no loser because we've seen a great fight between these two fighters.
Absolutely, and you can see the fans of Abib Oladeji very excited about it here. But I don't know, I think it's very close. Absolutely very close between these two boxers here. Going back to his corner, he felt probably a bit disappointed in himself. Maybe feeling like he should have actually dealt a harder lesson to this man here. And you can see Oladeji trying to, you know, embrace and hug and tell him we gave a good account of ourselves, but he wasn't really happy about it.
Yeah, I understand him. He's the best boxer, the most skillful boxer, and he's been in this game for quite some time. Anybody would have been disappointed in themselves.
Anyway, but you can't be disappointed when you fight a quality boxer. I'm pretty sure we're going to be looking to see more of this man. In a sense, we have seen a little what he packs down in his gloves.
I like how you do.
Ralph Chinozie George is standing by for the official announcement of this one.
Say mama, I keep quiet. Mama J never died.
Say Sammy Boss.
Say Sammy Gang.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, when you talk about the future of professional boxing in Nigeria in the bantamweight category, we will be talking about Sense and Ige. Please put your hands together for the two boxers. Brady and the two boxers have left it in the hands of the judges. And the judges have scored it this way. George Adesanya Olusegun scores it 58-56 for Ogbayemi Sense Adeyemi. George Seyi George scores it 56-58 for Ogbayemi Adeyemi. And George Latif Muiz scores it 57-57 for the winner by split decision. Ladies and gentlemen, the hard-hitting Sense Ogbayemi.
The fans going to leave it here, but I think we had the commentary. The decision of the judges, to be honest, it was a close
good
fight.
Evening.
But on the long haul, I think Sense dominated.
Can we listen?
He dominated it for bit of the.
Can we listen? These two boxers.
And what you
are my boxers.
Actually came to light. You said it was going to
they
be split.
Are my that was boxers.
The judge. The judge.
And I look forward to seeing the two of them
of the fans,
to fight for Nigeria in the nearest future.
Fight from,
whatever the result is
again,
now,
from our position,
I congratulate you.
He edged it.
I also congratulate you.
I've called it.
I'm going
absolutely
to give you another rematch.
One of the judges, Latif Muiz, scored
very soon.
I think.
So that we determine
the only situation I saw on the other side of the horizon
is
probably
the true champion. But I tell you,
only one of the judges,
when the judges give their decision,
look at the fight,
even myself as the MP,
56,
the president of the MPBFC,
and the other judge,
I don't have a choice. You have done so very well. You have done well. The judge, you should meet again. I will give you a rematch sometime in the nearest future. Congratulations.
You shouldn't be angry about this.
Thank
you. Boxing, one has to win, except, well, if it ends in a draw. But I'm pretty sure you can see the two of them. Even Habib knows.
Congratulations.
They've gone either way.
Yeah,
to the two boxers.
Written on his face.
Fantastic debut.
Proud of himself. He gave
for
it
Habib Ige.
And I don't think he should be disappointed. If there's anything, it is clearly up not from here for him.
Absolutely, I agree with you on that one.
Hey, Bado!
Still to come. We have a lot more.
How let's you doing?
Now, sir, Ralph Chidiose George.
Hey, Bado! Ilea Boxing Fiesta, brought to you by Lewis Promotions, bringing you the best of boxing. Hey, Bado, I've never had it so good.